Dear students, in this lecture we are going to understand the concept of electrical analogy in heat transfer. Before going to depth discussions of the electrical analogy in heat transfer, we just revise the various flow and their driving forces. If we discuss the electric system, then electric current is flow due to the presence of electric potential gradient. If we discuss the system of fluid, means a fluid motion of fluid, the motion of fluid is happening because of only the pressure gradient is available. It means without pressure difference, the fluid cannot be flow. So that is a driving force for flow of fluids. Similarly way, in heat transfer, we require the temperature gradient for flow of heat. It means heat cannot be flow without temperature difference. For flow of heat, we require a temperature difference. So now let us understand the concept of electrical analogy and thermal resistance. It is very important concept for solving a various numerical in conduction as well as the combined phenomena of conduction and convection. So we know that due to the voltage difference, the current flow through the electric system, and the system offers some resistance to flow of current. It means when the voltage difference are present, and due to that the current, it means the flow of charge is there, flow of electron is there, and when the flow of electrons are happening through the system offers the some amount of resistance, and that's why some amount of voltage is dropped between these two, between the resistance. So here we understand with the help of this figure. We have one resistance, that is electrical resistance. Voltage difference V1 and V2 is there. Current is flow in the directions of higher voltage to the lower voltage. It means V1 is greater than of V2. If we remember that we already know the Ohm's law, and Ohm's law is indicating that voltage V equals to IR. It means voltage drop equals to current flow into the resistance. So we can write for this circuit, V1 minus V2 is a voltage difference, R is a resistance of the system, which is equals to the I, that is a current flow. Similar way, if we discuss the thermal resistance in conduction, now let us consider the heat flow across the wall or slab. So here we have taken one slab. Of one side of slab, the temperature is TS1. And another side it is TS2. So there is a gradient. It means the temperature difference is generated. The length of wall or the length of slab is L, and the thermal conductivity of material is given, that is a K. Now we calculate the rate of heat flow across the given wall. So using the Fourier's law, we are able to calculate the Qx, which is equals to minus Ka dT by dx. So dx is the length between the two plane, and in this case the length between the two plane is L. So we will put it down, dx equals to L, and minus dt, it means t2 minus t1, but minus of that, it means t1 minus t2. So finally our equation, this equation is becomes minus is multiplying with this bracket, and we get ts1 minus ts2 into ak upon L, which is if we will rewrite the equation, then TS1 minus TS2 upon L by AK. Now using electrical terminology, if we draw the same circuit, that T1 is a temperature, T2 is another temperature, so this is a driving force for a heat. So due to the temperature difference, the heat is flow from the system, which offers the some amount of resistance due to the presence of thermal conductivity, and it is known as a thermal resistance. So we can write similar way as we write earlier, that temperature drops, which is a driving force. So we will write instead of the voltage difference in electric circuits, Q is a heat flow. In electric circuit, the current is flow. So we will replace I by Q. And there is a resistance, that is electric resistance. Here the resistance is a thermal resistance. So in this phenomena, that whatever the resistance offered by system, that we know as a thermal resistance. So now again, if we rewrite the equations, that voltage drop equals to current flow into the resistance, same way for the thermal circuit we will write a temperature drop equals to
heat flow into the thermal resistance. So we'll write it down, T1 minus T2 upon RTS, that is thermal resistance, equals to the heat flow, that is Q. Now we discuss the case of convection, the thermal resistance in the convection. So let us discuss the solid surfaces having a temperature of TS, the moving fluid is present, and the bulk fluid temperature is T infinite. Here the TS is greater than of T infinite. It means the bulk fluid temperature is lower than the surface temperature, and that's why the heat is flow from higher temperature, that is the surface temperature, to the lower temperature, that is bulk fluid temperatures. Here the Q amount of heat is flow from surface to the bulk fluid. A thermal resistance may be also associated with the heat transfer by convection at a surface. So now from Newton's law of cooling, we know that Q is a rate of heat transfer, H A T S minus T infinite. If we rewrite this equation in a form of thermal resistance, then we get the R thermal resistance for the convection equals to the temperature drop divided by the heat flow. And finally we will get these equations. If you rewrite this equation, if you rearrange this equation, then 1 upon HA equals to TS minus T infinite upon Q. So put down the value from this equation, that TS minus T infinite divided by Q, you get 1 upon HA. So in the case of the thermal conduction, you have the thermal resistance is L by AK. In case of the convections, you get the thermal resistance, that is 1 upon HA. So now discussing the various unit of the various parameter that used in the discussions, that heat flux Q dash, it is indicated by Q dash, watt per meter square is the unit, rate of heat flow Q watt joule per second. Thermal conductivity, it is indicated by K, watt per meter degree centigrade. Thermal resistance, it is R degree centigrade per watt. If we summarize the thermal resistance in the conduction, then R conduction equals to delta X by AK. And if we discuss the convection, then R means the thermal resistance in convection is 1 upon HA. Now we discuss the heat conduction through the three different layer materials. It means here the composite material we used, that is made of three different layers. Now considering the area A, that is constant for all the three layers, as well as the heat is transferred at steady rate through this composite material. So let us understand the composite, how the composite is made. So here the first layer is of material 1, which is having a thermal conductivity of K1. Second is 2 and having a thermal conductivity of K2, and third having a thermal conductivity of K3. But you can see from the figure, the cross-sectional area as well as the rate of heat transfer is a constant throughout this all the three layers. Now we consider the temperature, on the first slab, that is T1 and T dash. On second layer it is T dash and T double dash. In third layer it is T double dash and T2. So here if you know the temperature T1 and T2, but you need to find it out the interface temperature. Interface means the surface. This surface is connecting the layer 1 and layer 2. Similar way, this surface is connecting the layer 2 and layer 3. So these surfaces are known as interfaces between 1 and 2, and this surface is known as an interface surface between 2 and 3. Having a temperature of T dash and T double dash, and we are interested to find it out this temperature drops between these layers, as well as we will able to know how to calculate this unknown temperature between these slabs. So for that we are going for analysis of this composite layer, which is made of three layers. So here first I am applying the Fourier's law of heat conduction. So the flow, rate of flow across the layer 1 is Q dot. The temperature difference between these two, between the surfaces of layer 1, is T1 and T dash, having a thermal conductivity of K1, and area is A, common for all. So according to the Fourier's law, Q dot equals to minus K1 A dt by dx. So from that, if we remove the minus sign and rearrange the terms, that T1 minus T dash equals to Q dot 1 upon X1 by AK1. Similar way, whenever we are applying the Fourier's law between this layer of 2, it means the surface of layer 2, the temperature is T dash and T double dash having a thermal conductivity of K2, area is remains a constant. So our equation Fourier law of conduction is becomes Q dot equals to K2A divided by X2 into T dash minus T double dash. If you rearrange the equation, then you will get this equation. Now similar way, we are applying the Fourier's law for the third layer, which is equals to Q dot equals to K3A upon X3 into T double dash minus T2. If you rearrange this equation, we get the T double dash minus T2 equals to Q dot divided by 1 by X3 upon K3A. Now we are going to add it down this all three equations. All three equation means we are adding the right hand side of this equation, we are adding the left hand side of these equations. So T1 minus T dash plus T dash minus T double dash plus T double dash minus T2. So these terms T dash and T double dash is cancel it out, and finally we get T1 minus T2. That is a overall heat temperature, that is a overall temperature difference across the all the three layers. And Q dot is a rate of heat transfer which is constant from all the three layers. And here on the denominator sides, we get the resistance that is called as a thermal resistance that earlier we derived, that X upon Ka. So first layer, the thermal resistance is becomes X1 divided by A into K1. Similar way, the thermal resistance for the second is X2 divided by K2A. For the third layer, the thermal resistance is becomes X3 divided by K3 into A. So from these equations, we can write that R1 plus R2 plus R3 in denominator sides, and we are able to find it out the equivalent circuit by electronics way. So this is a resistance which is offered by the layer 1, this is a resistance for the heat offered by a layer 2, and this is a resistance 3 which is offered by a layer 3. So temperature between the first layer is T1 and T1 dash. For the second layer, it is T dash and T double dash. Here it is T double dash and T2. Similar way, R1, R2, R3 is given, and all the three means heat is flow, same heat is flow through all the layers. That's why we can say that the all the resistance are in the series. For electric network, the current is a flow medium, and if the current is constant through all the resistance, then we treat the all the resistance are in series. Similar way, here heat is flow. So if the flow of heat through all the layers are same, then we treat the resistance are in series. So this is a way we treat as a series connections of all the three layers for the thermal resistance, and in that way we are able to calculate the total resistance, which is equals to R1 plus R2 plus R3. R1, R2, R3 are the independent or the individual thermal resistance of the different layer. Now we discuss the conduction through wall. Here in this case we discuss the convection effect on both the sides of slab as well as the conduction effect inside a slab. It means on the one side there is a hot fluid is there which gives the heat to this layer, and temperature of this surface is TS1. Then heat is passing through the solid medium, it means by the mode of conductions. And here again on this solid surfaces we have a flow of fluids, it means there is a convection, and here it is a cold fluid. So the temperature here, it is a T infinite one, the heat is transferred to T infinite 1 to TS1, then TS1 to TS2 and TS2 to T infinite 2. It means the higher temperature is T infinite 1, then TS1 is slightly less than that, then TS2 is also less than of TS1, and then TS2 is less than of TS2. T infinite 2 is less than of TS2. Now if we draw by applying electrical analogy, if we draw the circuits, then it becomes here there is a convection is happening, so there is a convection between T infinite and TS1, there is a conduction between the TS1 and TS2, so we are applying the conduction thermal resistance, and third again it is a convection. So here, so convection resistance according to the Newton's law of cooling is 1 upon H1 into A. Similar way here, from the Fourier's law the thermal resistance for the conduction is x by ak. So here the length between the two surfaces is given, that is L. So we have write L divided by ak, and here it is a convection. Again we will write, that is h2 into a. Now question is arises in your mind that h1 and h2, h1 is the hot fluid side of the convective coefficient and h2 is a cold fluid side of convective heat transfer coefficient. So by this way we can able to convert the thermal systems into the electrical networks, or we can say is we are applying the electrical analogy for a thermal or the heat systems. Now we do the analyzing. Again, see here, the same heat is flow through this all the three resistance. It means the Qx is constant and we are applying the Fourier's law as well as the Newton's law of cooling for the conduction and convections. So here the first is convection happening between T infinite 1 and TS1. So T infinite 1 minus TS1 upon the resistance, that is 1 upon H1 into A. Similar way, here it is a conduction. So TS1 minus TS2 L by AK. Similar way, here it is a convection. TS2 minus T infinite 2, 1 upon H2 into A. Now overall heat transfer coefficient, if you want to find it out, overall means from beginning to the ends. So the temperature difference over here is T infinite 1 to the T infinite 2, and we will find it out the total resistance. So total resistance we calculated using the series connection of this resistance, that R1 plus R2 plus R3. What is R1? 1 upon H1 into A. R2 is L upon AK, and third one is 1 upon H2 into A. So this, in this way you can apply the electrical analogy for solving of the heat networks. Now composite wall. Composite wall, this case is a combinations of previous two. It means there is a convection, then conductions are happening on different layer. There is a three material, A, B and C. A, B and C. And again there is a convection. So here it is a, how we can plot the diagram. So here a convection, so we write it down, the convection resistance that happening into T infinite 1 into TA, we can write a surface temperature is TA, then TA to TB, there is L upon AK, then similar way TB to TC, here it is there, and TC to T surface temperature, so we can write this way, and here it is a T infinite, so again there is a convection resistance, and heat flow is a constant from all the surfaces and all the mediums. That's why we can treat, there is R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus R4 plus I5, which is equals to U A delta T. So by comparing these two equations, we are able to calculate U equals to 1 upon R total into A. It means this is R total, you have to multiply it with the A. So area is cancelled out from all the terms, because we are, see, in the resistance side, area is in denominator sides and we multiply it with that area, so area is cancelled out from all the terms, and finally we get the U equals to 1 upon H1 into A, because area is cancelled out, LA upon KA, LB upon KB, LC upon KC, plus 1 upon H2. So in this way, whenever there is composite heat conduction as well as the convection problem is there, you can be able to calculate the overall heat transfer coefficient using this formula. Now we are discussing a series and parallel. As earlier cases we are discussing the series connections. Suppose there are three mediums are given and the same heat flow is there, then we can consider as a series connections. But the case here we are discussing, the area of A is AA, area of B is not equals to area of A. It means the rate of heat flow, the rate of heat flow from A to B is not same. Similar way, A to C is not same. The heat comes from A is divided into B and C. It means QA, which is equals to QB plus QC. And QB and QC, the layer are separated by the insulating materials. It means B and C cannot be directly come in a contact, but it is comes in contact with A and B, A and C. Similar way, B is in contact with D, and C is also in contact with D, but B and C are not in contact, and area of A and B, which is equals to area of A and area of D, as well as length of B and length of C are equal. It means the length is equal. So we can analyze the C. Here the heat flow is QA. QA is divided into the two parts, QB and QC. Again here QB and QC are meet with each other and it becomes a QD. So in this way, we have the network. There's one resistance are in series, the another two are parallel with each other, and third one is also in series. So first, how we can write the equations? The overall heat transfer, we can calculate with T1 minus T2 divided by R total. So R total is becomes R1 plus R equivalent of B and C plus R3. Here we cannot directly write that RB plus RC because these two are in parallel. We know the formula to calculate the equivalent resistance when the resistance are in parallel that we have learned in electrical, that 1 upon R equals to 1 upon R1 plus R2. Here B and C are in parallel. So we will write 1 upon RB plus 1 upon RC equals to 1 upon R equivalent. And R equivalent is calculating. If you give the simplification, then RTH means the thermal resistance of B into R thermal resistance of C divided by RB plus RC. In this way, you can able to calculate R equivalent. You have to put down the value over here, and using the R1 and R3, you will be able to calculate the total resistance, and from total resistance you will be know the unknown temperatures or the rate of heat transfer. So in this way, we can able to calculate the unknown quantities which is given in various cases. So this is a ending of this video. These concepts are very important for solving a various problem of conduction and the conduction and convection combined effect. Thank you, and make a note of this all the cases in your notebook. Thank you.